Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. And if you're new, then hi, welcome. I hope you stick around. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button down there, because then you will be a part of a little cozy family here on my channel. And that will mean the world to me if you do that. So today is going to be another declutter video in my series I got here on my channel. And I'm going to link all the others down below so you can see them. So today I'm going to go through all my contours, bronzers, blushes and highlighters. So if you like to see that, then keep on watching. So today we are going to take a look at this drawer and ta-da! Yeah, I know, I got a big problem. This area is only all my blushes, and then I got some bronzers and some contours over here, and my highlights in the back, and some small palettes of Mix Max over here. But we are starting off with my bronzers and contours. And the first one I'm going to pick up is this Red and Wild contouring palette. And I really love this one, so it's definitely going to stay. And the next I got is this Broken Rimmel Natural Bronzer in Sunlight. So this is going because it's broken. And I got a brand new one, so I'm definitely going to keep this one. And then I got my Wet n Wild Color Recon Bronzer, and I really love this bronzer, so it's definitely going to stay. And then I got this little contour palette from e.l.f. This is amazing. It's a really good one, and for the price, I'm really loving it. I only use this shade the most, sometimes this one, and this one mixing with this, but not the highlight that much. So yeah, I'm going to keep this one. And the next one I got is this most used and loving palette I got here in my bronzing section. This is my Elizabeth Arden Bronze Duo in Bronze Beauty. And this is such a gorgeous color. This one is the one I'm used the most. And as you can see, this is such a pretty color. I really, really love this one, so it's definitely going to stay. And next up, I got this Dior Skin New Tan BB Cream in 001. And I have to be honest, I haven't tried it that much. So I'm going to keep this for the summer and see how it goes. And then I got this new one. This is the bronzing powder from CN. You can get this in Lidl. And this is in the shade 03 Bronze Shimmer. So I'm going to keep this to see how it goes and if it's good or not. And then I got this little e.l.f. Shimmer Face Whip Bronzing thing, I think it is. This is in the shade Golden Peach. But as you can see, I have barely touched it. So I'm going to give this a try because I'm getting more into liquid highlighters and bronzers and all that. So I'm really want to see how it goes with this. Then I got this Origins Multi Grain Makeup in the shade 02 Light Medium. And this is definitely too dark for me, so this is going. And then I got another one. This is in the shade Golden, and you can use this as a bronzer maybe, but I really haven't touched this since I got it, so this is going. And then I got this, I don't know what brand this is from, Sunkissed Metallic Bronzing Blush, and I have never ever touched it, but it's looking so pretty when you swatch it. So I'm going to keep it and see how it goes. And next up we got the Drew the Hula from Benefit, and this is the liquid one, and I'm really a big fan of this, considering I'm not into liquid highlighters and bronzers and blushes and all that. I really like this, so I'm going to keep this. And then I got this Gush. This is some little pearls in here to highlight with and bronze with, but I'm going to get rid of this one because I had it for so long, I have never used it. Next up is also from Goss. This is Pure Mineral Powder in Tan. And I really don't know because it's way too dark for me. But I think I will keep it for now and see if I could use this as a bronzer and some contour maybe. So keeping this. And the last thing I got is this liquid light highlighting from Japan Screw. I think it's pronounced. It's French, I think. So yeah. But I'm going to keep this because it's a very, very pretty color. So yeah. So next up, we're going to take all my blushes. And I know this is going to be a big struggle for me because I love all my blushes. Even though I'm not using all of them, but I love them all. I'm going to try really, really hard to get rid of some of them because I don't use them all. But we will start from the end and just go through all these lines. But first up, I got this e.l.f. blush. And yeah, this is a very unique color. So I'm definitely going to keep this one. Next up, I got this Rimmel Royal Blush. This is a cream blush in the shade called Queen. And I don't know because this is such a pretty color. But yeah, oh, I'm going to keep it. I can't help myself. And then I got this Third Boy from the Balm. And I love this one, so I'm definitely going to keep this. And next up, I got this Essence Blush in the shade number 10, Miss Flora Coral. And this is such a pretty blush. Yeah, I'm going to keep it because I'm a sucker for coral blushes. Next up, we got this e.l.f. blush in the shade PC Keen. And this is such a pretty color. Oh, love, 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 love it. So I'm going to keep it. Then I got this NYX Baked Blush in the shade Journey. Yeah, Journey. And this is such a pretty pink color, so I'm definitely going to keep this one. By the way, I don't hope the lighting is too bad over here because I got a window right over there, so it can maybe affect my picture a little bit, but I really hope you can see something. But we are moving on to this CN, I think it's pronounced. This is the Rouge Powder in the shade Nectarine. And then I got another one. This is Apricot. And these two are brand new to my collection, so I'm going to keep these and see how it goes. And then I got this e.l.f. blush, and I really don't know what to think about this. This is in the shade Koi. I think. Yeah, I don't know. I've never used it. But it's a very, very unique, pretty color. You can see it right there. I will give this a try, and if it doesn't work out, I'm going to get rid of it. Next up, we got my NYX blush in the shade Angel, and I really love this blush, so I'm definitely going to keep it. Next up, we got Benefit Benetint. And I have never used this. Oh, maybe a couple of times I can see that. But I think I'm going to get rid of this one because I'm not a fan of it. Yeah, I'm going to get rid of this one. And next up, we got these two e.l.f. Baked blushes. And this is in the shade Pinktastic. And the other one, I can't see a name on this. But these two are so pretty, so I'm definitely going to keep both of them. And next up, we got my two beloved Milani blushes. This is Luminoso and Rose d'Oro. And I really love these two, so I'm definitely going to keep them. This is going so pretty good, right? Or maybe not. I'm sucking at this area because I know I'm loving all my blushes, but maybe I can see some over here that can go, so I really, really hope. But next up, we got this Chanel blush, and this is in the shade Illusion, I think. And whoops, oh, the mirror just fell off. Okay, that's okay because I'm going to get rid of this one. This is, has no pigmentation at all, as you can see. Nothing. Nothing. You can just sit here and put your finger in it for hours and nothing happens. So, going to say goodbye to this one. Next up, we got my Maybelline Pure Plus Mineral in the shade Quartz Peach. And I really love this one. This is my all-time favorite blush. And this is discounted, so I don't know where I can get it when this is done. And yeah, it's done very, very soon. I can see that because I don't have so much powder in it. But definitely going to keep this one. And then I got my MAC Peaches. I'm going to keep this one because I'm loving it. And then I got this Wet n Wild in the shade Mellow Wine. And this is such a pretty blush and a forever blush. So if you haven't tried this out, you must. This is such a pretty color. This is... Oh, this is so pretty. Can you see that? Right there. Oh, it's such a pretty color. So I'm going to keep this one for sure. Next up we got my Dior blush, and I don't know what color it is because the whitening on the back is gone. But this looked like this, and I have major pan on it, so I really hope I can use this up in the future. But I'm going to keep this one because we all need a bright pink color in our collection. So yeah, keeping. And next up we got all these L'Oreal Blush Minerals, and I'm going to get rid of all of these because I have them for so many years. This was one of my first blushes I bought when I got into makeup, so I'm definitely going to get rid of these. And then I got this little blush sample size, and I don't know what brand it is, maybe Origins, but I'm going to keep this one because this is such a pretty color in the winter and fall time, so keeping. And then I got this little also sample size. This is from Dior, I think. And I'm going to get rid of this one because I've never used it. Next up we got these two from Clinique. And I'm going to keep both of them because they are so pretty. So keeping. Then the last section down here. And I'm going to take this out because this is taking too much space. And then you can see all my highlighters. This is the little mini drawer of highlighters, and first up is my really, really loved e.l.f. shimmer in the shade Gold, and I'm definitely going to keep this one because I can't live without this. Then I got this pixie highlighter in the shade London Luster, and definitely going to keep this one. This is so pretty. And then I got my Becca in Champagne Pop, and yeah, we all have that, don't we? But I'm going to keep this one because I'm loving it. And then I got this Marilou from The Balm, and yeah, you know, this is a must have in our collection, so I'm definitely going to keep this. Then I got this Immediate Makeup Liquid Highlighting in Diamond Heart. And I really don't know if I'm going to keep this or not. It's looking really, really pretty in a swatch. But yeah, I really don't know. I don't know if you can see that. It's a very sheer and very natural. But I think I'm going to keep this because I haven't tried it out yet. And then I can't have my full opinion on this. So keeping this for now. And next up we got this Maybelline Master Soap and Stick. And I really love this for under my foundation. For a little bit of glow or something. So yeah, definitely going to keep this one. And then I got this H&M Rapid Highlighter in the shade Rose Pearl. And this is such a pretty highlighter. So I'm definitely going to keep this one. This is so intense. Like really, really intense. If I don't know if you can see that. This is just one little swipe. I really love this. So definitely going to keep this one. And next up we got this Manacata Highlighting and Bronze Duo, and I really, really like this one, so it's definitely going to stay. Next up we got this Gauss Lumi Drops in the shade 002 Vanilla, and yeah, I haven't used this so much, but I really want to in the summertime, so I'm definitely going to keep this one. And last but not least, this is the Clinique Get Gorgeous Highlight. And this is an insane highlight. like really insane. I don't know if you can see that. It's such a pretty color. But I see myself not reaching for this anymore, so I think I'm going to get rid of this one. And the last three things I got is these small palettes. The first one is this Rimmer Kate palette in the shade 02 called Glow. And this is okay. The pigmentation is not that crazy. On the blush it is, but not on this bronzer. And this highlight is okay. This is not crazy. So I think I'm going to get rid of this one because I'm not using this at all. Next up we got my Sauvage Rose Golden palette, and I really love this palette. This is an amazing palette and have been in one of my favorites. So yeah, I'm definitely going to keep this one. Last but not least, this is my Sleek Makeup highlighting palette in Clotopia Kiss, and this is such a pretty palette. But these two I find really, really chunky, the powder ones, so I'm not going to use these. But I really like the cream ones, so I'm going to keep that until I don't have any left of these, and then I'm going to get rid of it. This is the final result, and I'm really, really happy about how it turned out, because yeah, I really need it. And these are all the products I'm going to get rid of, and yeah, I know that is not crazy many, but I really need to use some of my blushes up, and maybe I can get some new ones added to my collection. So yeah, that was all for my declutter video today, and if you like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to hit the subscribe button, and then I'll see you in my next video. Bye!